Okay, so listen. Listen to this song.
Uptown funk you up. Uptown funk you up. Uptown funk you up. Uptown funk you up.
And now listen to this one.
Say oops, up, your head.
I'm back at you again.
Upside your head.
Radio station is WGAP.
Say oops, upside your head.
Did you notice what they have in common? Drop a like if you notice something. Before we start, make sure to like this video to join the monthly iPhone X giveaway. And subscribe. Top 10 Rip-Off Songs. Good composers borrow, great composers steal. Some composers get caught. Creativity spawns creativity, as they say. But sometimes the line between influence and plain robbery gets a little blurred. Here are top 10 similar-sounding songs that were subject to plagiarism claims after their creators allegedly stepped on the wrong side of this mark. The song, One Direction, Steal My Girl. No formal accusations have been made against One Direction's songwriting teams, but Steal My Girl was accused of pilfering from Newfound Glory's It's Not Your Fault, and Live While We're Young from The Clash's Should I Stay or Should I Go. The outcome? Nothing. Harry Styles has admitted the similarities between Live While We're Young and The Clash hit were kind of on purpose, while Julian Bunetta, who co-wrote Steal My Girl, said, "At the end of the day, the lyric and the melody have nothing to do with any other song that I have ever heard." Miley Cyrus's We Can't Stop and Flurgon's We Run Things. Cyrus was slapped with a $300 million copyright infringement lawsuit in March 2018 over her 2013 song We Can't Stop. Jamaican songwriter Michael May, whose stage name is Flurgon, claims her song took about 50% from his song. He also wants to stop future sales and performances of the song. Listen to We Can't Stop and We Run Things. Ed Sheeran's Thinking Out Loud and Marvin Gaye's Let's Get It On. TMZ reported in June 2018 that Ed Sheeran is facing a $100 million lawsuit, alleging he copied Gaye's Let's Get It On. It was filed by Structured Asset Sales, a company that owns one-third of the copyright to Let's Get It On. Sheeran was sued back in 2016 over the same song by co-writer Ed Townsend. On Thursday, January 3rd, U.S. District Judge Lewis Stanton said there were substantial similarities between Sheeran's and Gaye's song and determined that the case should go to a jury. A New York jury will later decide the case. Listen to Thinking Out Loud and Let's Get It On.
Will your eyes still smile from your cheeks? Darling, I've been really trying. Could still fool us, heart at 23.
The song, Robin Thicke, Pharrell Williams, T.I., Blurred Lines. Robin Thicke and Pharrell Williams came under fire from Marvin Gaye's family for plagiarism. After Thicke said in interviews that he had drawn on the feel of Gaye's 1977 single, Got to Give It Up. The courts ruled in favor of Gaye's family, and Thicke and Williams were ordered to pay $4 million in damages and $3.4 million in profits from the alleged copyright infringement. So in total, that's about £4.8 million. The decision sets a horrible precedent for music and creativity going forward, said the pair's lawyer.
Everybody get up.
The song, Avril Lavigne, Girlfriend. The accusation? Twofold. Those bratty hey chants were too like Tony Basil's 1982 annoyer Mickey for the internet's liking. But the Rubinus actually filed a lawsuit because lyrically Girlfriend was very similar to their song, I Wanna Be Your Boyfriend. The outcome? Levine settled out of court with her accusers, and the Rubinos experienced something of a resurgence in popularity as a result of the media attention. The song? Coldplay, Viva La Vida. The accusation? Creaky Boards compared their song, The Songs I Didn't Write, to Coldplay's sports soundtracking favorite Viva La Vida in mid-2008, saying Coldplay had heard it at one of their October 2007 gigs. Later that year, Joe Satriani claimed it had ripped off his 2004 instrumental, If I Could Fly. The outcome? Chris Martin had an alibi for the Creaky Boards gig and produced a demo of Viva La Vida from February 2007, so Creaky Boards retracted the allegation and said both bands must have been inspired by The Legend of Zelda. As for Satriani's case, it was dismissed by the court. Bruno Mars and Mark Ronson, and the Gap Band. Though influenced by numerous funk songs from the 70s and 80s, Uptown Funk had to add additional writer credits after the Gap Band filed a copyright claim. The band now earns a 17% share of the publishing royalties. Listen to Uptown Funk and Oops Upside Your Head.
Let me tell y'all a little something. Uptown Funk you up. Uptown Funk you up. Uptown Funk you up. Uptown Funk you up.
Say oops, upside your head.
I'm back at you again.
Upside your head.
Radio station is
WGAP.
Say oops, upside your head.
Lana Del Rey's Get Free and Radiohead's Creep. Lana Del Rey took to Twitter to claim that Radiohead was suing her and that the lawyers were relentless. According to NME, Radiohead's publishers denied any lawsuit and just said that the group wanted writing credit. To set the record straight, no lawsuit has been issued, and Radiohead have not said that they will only accept 100% of the publishing of Get Free, a statement read. During her performance at Lollapalooza, Brazil in March, the singer said the lawsuit was over. Listen to Get Free and Creep. Sam Smith's Stay With Me and Tom Petty's I Won't Back Down. Tom Petty's publishers contacted Smith after hearing similarities between the two songs, particularly during the chorus. They reached an out-of-court agreement to list Petty and Jeff Lynne as co-writers on the song. Petty released a statement saying, "All my years of songwriting have shown me these things can happen. Sam's people were very understanding of our predicament and we easily came to an agreement." Listen to Stay With Me and I Won't Back Down.
Oh, won't you stay with me? 'Cause you're all I need. Well, I won't back down. No, I won't back down.
So that's it for today's video. Let me know what you think, and if you have any other suggestions in the comments down below. And if you enjoyed today's video, please leave a like, as it helps me a lot. My Instagram will be in the description down below if you want to check that out. For more original content published every week, be sure to subscribe. See you guys in the next one. Bye!